Hi, I'm Xplicit Dezigns. My name is Lay Pasava, also known as Xplicit or X, whichever. And this is actually my third class here in the Bay. Probably my largest class so far. Decided to have a first class a few months ago, which kind of boomed and led to a second class. Pretty excited about it. Gonna change a few lives today. I wanna see what everyone has in store. Let's get to it. Whoa. Are they both mine?
Yes.
Hey, brother. This is Jordy. He's from my second class. He was the one who broke the machine. And he ended up making two pairs of these. So,
Pay it back.
He had to pay me back.
Yeah.
I didn't want the money. He was going to send money through the mail, but I was like, nah. I said, just make me some pants. Yeah, so he did a real good job. He has all the equipment now. So he's gonna be a good one.
Be on the
lookout.
Another
one of the greats right here. Remember his name. Jordy. Yeah, I shout him out all the time.
Hey man, you look like you're ready for Complex Con. Hey,
you already know, bro.
Those are fire.
Y'all can't handle this. That's what I'm saying. Y'all can't handle this team, brother.
This is what happens when you take the Xplicit class.
That's what happens. That's what happens when you actually do your work.
Oh, yeah.
Whenever I saw the MCM, the little baby ones, I was like, what the hell? At first, I was talking to him. He was like, man, I got to pay you back somehow, bro. Next thing you know, he posted a little shorts. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I was like, damn. This dude went from here to here. He just jumped like that, bro. Yeah, they sick, bro. They sick.
Hey, guys. I'm your cameraman today. If you don't know me, I'm Alex, Sneakerheadinthebay. Go ahead and follow me, okay? Follow me on Instagram and YouTube. And follow everybody else. We'll try to link everybody's Instagrams down below in the description. This is Lay's video. This is Xplicit's video. I'm just gonna be capturing the next few days. All right, hopefully I do it well for you guys. Hit that like button. Make sure you subscribe to the homie's channel. Super excited today. I'm gonna be a mentor as well. We got 3 to 4-ish. I think mentors coming through from the previous classes, so should be good. It's gonna be a big class. This location's pretty tight, not gonna lie. Best location we've had so far. Don't try. I walk in room, they eyes wide. Third album come soon. I'm glad y'all gon' die. I ain't chasing after no. I got bigger plans. What's up, bro?
What's going on?
How do you feel to be returning to this class as a mentor?
That feels a lot better than what I started off with. I didn't know what I was doing, and now I'm able to help and give back, help everyone else that needs the help or goes through something that I went through that I didn't have help from and that I had to go on and overcome myself.
Today we're supposed to have 23, but I think we're gonna have around 22 students today. Should be here any second now.
All right, everybody, this is Dylan right here. He is the first student that popped up about an hour early. Very punctual. How are you feeling right now?
Feeling pretty anxious, nervous. Tried to get some sleep last night, but now I'm here, so I'm excited and ready to go.
As far as expectations go for the class, what do you expect?
Just to make new friends and then end Sunday with a talent that I can have for a lifelong period of my life and see where it goes from there. To your death without warning, get out the way, get out the way, get out the way, yeah. Get out the way, get
somebody sent me a DM and said, hey, these new Apple Watch bands were coming out, and can you make me a watch band out of a handbag? I said, shit, I'll just do it right now over the dinner table, you know. So I just grabbed a piece of paper, drew a little pattern together. I didn't even finish dinner, to be honest, man. I just went ahead and just put together a watch band, posted it. By the time dinner was over, it just blew up over like 1,000 likes. And so it just blew up from there. And so the help, there's gonna be a few guys. They all have the X shirts on. Alex, I don't know where he's at.
Right.
Yeah, you guys know him. He's from the Bay Area. Yeah, Sneakerhead in the Bay. He's gonna be my photographer, and he took the first class. I'll let him explain a little bit more later about him and how it changed his life and what he wanted from the class and how we became friends.
I mean, make friends. That's like my main tip. Make friends, take notes, and just have fun with it. Be creative. And if you guys have any questions, just let us know.
All right. And Amador, he took the second class. He's the one in the black shirt. He's from San Angelo, Texas. He came out here, volunteered. You know, like I just basically asked anyone from the class to volunteer if they wanted to come out here. And he flew out here on his own. I just wanted to come help out, you know. And I'll let him tell you his story of why he took the class.
I got tired of it because I'm working 12 hours, 4 days on, 4 days off, working overtime and everything. And if I can do that, to do this as a side hustle, and then see where it takes me to make more money, this is even plus. But me taking the class even became something more life-changing, because now that I can help these people, I'm able to help y'all and give back to everyone else. And I'm in like a everlasting debt to Lay, because he brought everything more to life to me. Once you take this class, you're gonna see entirely different world. You're gonna be seeing things differently. You're gonna be looking at people differently. You're gonna be able to call this your family and help each other.
And Jordy, I mean, if you've been following my Instagram, he's the one that makes these. He came in here and surprised me with these, right? So he was probably my worst student from the last class. He broke the machine. He was gonna give up. He was gonna go home the next day. He didn't tell me he was gonna go home the next day, but if he said, if I said anything to offend him, he was gonna go home, right? So, I mean, I told you a little bit about that, and I'll let him explain a little bit more on that.
Basically, what this did for me was the support. The support that I get, I can start posting that I'm doing something, and 10 people hit me up. Go, dude, go. You know, just the family environment, the, you got this, you know, you can do whatever you want. But like I said, don't be like me. Don't get crippled by anxiety, because you're here. This is where you want to mess up. This is where you want to make a mistake, because you're here and we're here to help you, you know what I'm saying? And you're gonna go home and you're gonna make the same mistakes, but you're gonna be in the Discord and you got everybody, the support, the family, you know? So everybody comes together and stuff like that.
I mean, it means the world, not just like, you know, you just go into a store and just buy it or somebody else, you know? But it was one that you actually taught. You know, so that actually really comes from the heart, that he took the time to cut the pattern and sew and put it together, you know, to bring it and have me wear it. He sat in this room, man, like it wasn't all in a room like this. It was like three rooms. I separated them. I put four to each room. He sat there by himself, all quiet. And that machine was broken for like a while. You know, I was like, why would you use the machine? So I came around, tried to change the bobbin and everything. I lifted it up. I fixed the, you know, the rods, the gears and everything. Adjusted in every way. But I noticed him in the back. He never said anything. You know, I said, what's up, Jay? You good, man? What's going on back there? You know, he said, yeah, I'm good. Yeah, you know, I was like, man, if you ain't good, man, let me know, bro. You know what I mean? I hope you're doing well. So I go back to doing all this stuff. And, I felt like kind of like he was kind of down. But I walked over and I helped him with his watch bands. I took him to another machine. I watched him sew, I helped him sew until he got confident again. I even did one run for him to get him to be more confident and open up a little bit. And that's what I want you guys to do, open up to everybody. Don't be so full of yourself. You're gonna make mistakes. These machines are meant for y'all. I want y'all to break these machines. I don't want y'all to break y'all's machines. That's what they're here for. Y'all pay for the class, y'all pay for the machines. Trial and error on these machines, that's what they're here for. I want to take the loss. I don't want you guys to take the loss, you get me? I want you guys to go home winners, that you got something from the class and it changed your life, you know? I don't even want you to think about these machines in the back of your mind like Jordan did. You know, I gotta pay you back, bro, I gotta do this. Don't even think like that, you know? Just use the machine like you would use your machine. You know, it's not gonna come out perfect. You're gonna perfect your craft whenever you get back home, whenever you do it on your own. right? These times, you're not gonna perfect this craft. You're not gonna get it done on the first time. Some, very rare, you know, very rare. Alex was pretty good at it, you know what I mean? But he took a lot of notes.
So my name is Dylan. I'm from San Jose, found your page off of Rocky. Got a whole bunch of ideas I wanna do, and taking this class can further that and have a lifelong talent with me that I can carry anywhere.
My name's Nick from New Orleans. Kinda customize shoes on the side. I bartend mainly. I wanted to take this class just to kinda like put some more product out there and, you know, better myself, better anybody around me.
My name is Maribel. I'm taking this class because I've always been interested on leather work. My husband started following some of you guys first, and then, you know, he introduced me to your pages. Just fell in love with the products, with, you know, what you guys create. And I used to be a librarian, and now I wanna, you know, do something for me.
Kirill, I'm from Denver. I just took this class to learn something new. I haven't been even following you for that long. I just like this type of shit.
You like it? I deal, bro.
My name is Ivan. I'm from Richmond, California. I followed you from Alex. I saw the work and I really had some ideas I wanted to do. And I wanted to take the class before this. I didn't have enough money. No, got some help and I got to take this one. I'm pretty excited, pretty nervous.
Tony, I'm from Houston. I'm already into like music and fashion. Just basically took the class to make what I want to make like everyone else. Clothes, shoes, you know, Dapper Danish kind of, you know.
Hey, my name is Brisky. I'm part owner of a recording studio out in Arizona. So like I have a lot of time on my hands too, but I don't really make money unless I'm there on an hourly basis. So right now I offer a service, but I need products so I can make money without being present and just, you know what I'm saying, while I sleep. So that's more so why I took the class. He definitely kept putting it in my ear too. So I mean, and I've seen plenty of the work, so definitely wanted to learn it.
I'm Louie and I'm from Philly. What I hope to take from this class is to learn how to do all this. And what I expect is just to make some ballin' ass shit when I'm done.
I'm Los, I'm from Richmond, California. I got a background in audio engineering, did it for like 15 years. Kinda got like away from it. My mentor actually taught me how to graphic design. As of like last year, year and a half, I started developing my own brand. But I said, you know, like screen print with other companies, this, that, and other. I wanted to do my own cutting, so I take stuff to tailors, and it just costs a lot of money to take stuff to the people. And I've always been a hands-on person my whole life, and I was like, I just want to do this myself.
My name is Rith. I got a background in metal fabrication, CNC and all that stuff, welding. I took that to another level. I started doing gold, so I was making jewelry. I was saving up for GIA in SoCal, but I fought away for like 2 years. So when he posted up in the Bay Area, I was like, you know what? Class can wait, because this is a once-in-a-lifetime thing, so I just thought,
man. My name's Alvin from Toronto. Been watching Alex for a while, like, since elementary school, and then posted that video from you back then with the Louis Vuitton slides. I was like, well, I need those for myself, but like, I was broke back then. I'm still broke, but.
You ain't gonna be broke after this.
And I've always liked designer stuff, and like I just want to make random designer things with leather and stuff. Yeah.
Well, my name is Keith. I'm from Philly. Took the class to learn some things and yeah, do my own thing.
So I'm Cal. I'm from Jersey, Philly area, but right now I live in Arizona. The reason why I took this class is because my boy Eric, he told me to look into it. And I'm also like a hands-on type of person. I like to like search on YouTube, try and figure out stuff out for myself. And so I want to see how far it goes.
I'm Jasper, I'm out here from the Bay. The reason I want to take this class is really, I want to get away from, I do like just like tech and stuff, like get away from like 9 to 5 and shit and really pursue what I've always wanted to do. And this is an opportunity to really make handcrafted goods that I've always wanted to kind of build upon. I literally don't have any, you know, sewing experience, anything like that, but I do feel like this is a great opportunity to learn more and kind of expand on that.
Hi everybody, I'm Cassandra. I'm from Oklahoma, but I moved to Vegas. I got my guard card and decided that wasn't for me, and I turned to stripping. I just wanted to restart, and I want to learn a lot, and I know I'm nervous, so it's going to be a hard journey, but I think I can do it.
I'm Landry from Calgary, Alberta, Canada. I've been following you for a very long time. Yeah, I have a good job and all that, but I've always wanted to do my thing. I draw a lot of design on my own. Like I'm creative with, you know, putting the designs together, but I have no sewing idea. Like I can draw it, but I cannot make it. And so this was a good opportunity to just come and learn and then, you know, see how far I can take it from there.
Alejandro, I'm from here, San Francisco, born and raised.
I found out about this through Carlos. As he said, he has a brand and we've spoken about it, trying to bring it to life, and I really believe in the brand. Been trying to find a way to start. I'm not really sure how to go about it, and he told me about this, started looking into it, and just thought this is a one better place to start. This seems like it's gonna be one of a very strong, good foundation, both with skill and just people networking, so. Thanks for having me here.
I've known Lay for probably about 4 or 5 years. I've always had a thing for creating. So I have a little bit of background in sewing, self-taught, YouTube, made custom hats, made this jersey right here, custom jerseys. I've always wanted to learn type of leather work because it's a lost art. You research and look for classes and you can't find any. So when I saw that Lay was, you know, doing his thing, I wanted to go to the first class, the second class, I couldn't make it, and when I found out he was having it in the Bay, I was like, I can't miss it, right? What I want to get out of here is networking with everybody, helping everybody out. You know, if somebody has a weakness, you help them with your strengths and vice versa. It's all about helping each other out and getting each other to the next level. So I want to see everybody succeed as well.
My name is Eric from Philly originally. I live in Arizona now. Basically, I've been into fashion for a long time. Just started getting back into like making music recently. I'm at Brisky, and I work a full-time job, and it's been kind of draining my creative energy. So I kind of figured something like this would definitely help with kind of building my image, branding myself. And I met Lay. I stumbled upon his page, and basically got a Gucci dog collar from him. Asked him if he could make me a custom off-white camera strap, and we just kind of like built it from there.
Hi guys, I'm Aaron. I'm from Michigan. I always liked to like customize stuff, hands-on stuff, and I used to work with my dad in a factory throughout high school. I'm a barber now. I've been a barber for almost 2 years. My goal is to have knowledge, because knowledge is key, because they can't take that away from you. They can take everything else away from you besides knowledge. So my goal now is to give back to my parents because of what they give to me. So I'm doing what I can and trying to learn my best. And for my parents and my daughter, I have a kid now.
My name is Arthur, I'm from the city. I've known Lay for some time now. I took the class to basically learn another skill. I like to be well-rounded with knowledge. Help me out if I want to start doing my own custom car parts material.
The main goal is just investing in myself. Like you stated on the website, when I purchased a class, a seat, investing in yourself is like key. Having the freedom of working for yourself is like the best feeling, I feel like. I mean, I'm not experienced, I'm still working 9 to 5 and stuff like that, but in the future, hopefully, I mean, I can work for myself and have that freedom of working whenever I choose or, you know, stuff like that. But yeah, I'm excited to be here. I'm like, I also don't have no experience in sewing and stuff like that. So this is a great opportunity for me. I mean, hopefully, I don't think there's gonna be another opportunity, so I took the chance and I'm here now. Get the most, not the lesser. Trash like the fuck with $40 in the club. Fucking up the game, bitch, it gets no love. She be cross country giving all that she got. 1,000 a pop, I'm pulling Bentleys off the lot. I smashed up the gray one, bought me a red. Every time we hit the parking lot, we turn head. Some hoes wanna choose, but them bitches too scary. Your bitch chose me, you ain't a pimp, you a fairy.
Headed to class, day 2. Yesterday was day 1. 23 students out of 25. Tired, ready to get it. Let's get to it.
Take the other side, both sides, on top of that. And I'll show you here in a second. All right, so I take both sides like that. I make shit look easy, but they don't know what it take. Don't ask me the time, I got baguettes in the face. Virgil drops on Louis, I want everything he made. When it come to hoes, I never be the one to save. Keep on throwing ones, these bitches keep on showing ass. Bitches on my body and I'm just trying to relax. They always come off cool, but in the end they come out whack. The boyfriend getting mad, I told her he could take you back. Have you ever been with a boss? I know you're
your boyfriend took you shopping. Right now they're working on gluing the ends, the connectors, and the buckles, and then we're gonna get to sewing, putting the leather on.
Yeah,
so that's what they're doing right now. Some of them working on keychains.
I'm always dripping, I leave puddles when I walk. If she don't know how to dress, I wanna talk. But I may still get some top. I don't need about my pockets full of knots. Number one is finally real ones at the top. I'm with Mustard and we talking Lambo talk. I make sure look easy, but they don't know what it take. Don't ask me the time, I got baguettes in the face. Rojo drops on Louis, I want everything he made. When it come to hoes, I never be the one to say.
Going to dinner? Family dinner, actually. Everyone going out to eat at the class. So this Saturday, everybody out here. Gift box back there. Sneakerhead out here. Mm-hmm. Ivan. Mm-hmm. We got everybody out here. We got the whole clique, the whole crew.
How many people are gonna show up?
Man, I'm trying to get like at least 23. Michael Jordan out there.
Ooh.
23, but it's gonna be more. It's gonna be like about 30.
Ooh.
30 people going out there.
Wow.
Have a good time, crank it up. It's Chase Center right here. That's where we're gonna party right after.
That's nice.
What's up? To the next one, to the next one.
Yeah.
Walt Disney World.
That's the next class?
Yes, sir.
All right, you heard
right
it here first.
Right in the middle of downtown Disney. You heard it here first, right. Is on me, but it's just one person. I know you're getting like really, really, really messed up. The class tomorrow and not being able to finish the watch bench. Right? So let's just do the one. And I may just be one with y'all. And I'm not a drinker or something. So I'm going to show my love. You know, I show my love to you guys because I do love every one of you. You know, I want to see you guys progress. All right? I want to see every one of you progress and I want to see every one of you help each other, all right? So whenever you guys do this, and whenever you guys show up next year, whenever we have the reunion, you guys are taking me out.
Yeah.
All right, that's what's up, all right? Yeah. All right. So y'all remember that.
Hey, we'll go out after this.
Yeah.
I needed to hear that shit. I hate when you're submissive. Passive aggressive when we're texting, I feel the distance. I look around at peers that surround me, these niggas tripping. I like when money makes a difference, but don't make you different. Started realizing a couple places I could take it. I wanna get back to when I was that kid in the basement. I wanna take it deeper than money, pussy vacation. And influence a generation that's lacking the patience. I've been dealing with my dad speaking of lack of patience. Just me and my old man getting back to basics. We've been talking about the future and time that we wasted. When he put the bottle down, girl, that nigga's amazing. Well, fuck it, we had a couple coronas. We might have wrote a white paper, just something to hold us. We even talked about you in our couple of moments. He said we should hash it out like a couple of grown-ups. You a flower child, beautiful child, I'm in your zone.
Oyster time, baby.
Yeah, that's pretty good.
Clam chowder time.
Ready?
Fire.
Looking like you came from the 70s on your own. My mother is 66 and a favorite line that hit me with is who the fuck wants to be 70 and alone.
Today is day 3. Shut down shop today, man. Just do it. Bust in there and just kill. And then got all my gear. I'm about to go all dripped out, brother.
Oh yeah.
Yes sir, yes sir. One of my students is a drip lord. So what I'm gonna do today is, today's the last day. I'm gonna go inside. I'm gonna pull a troll on him big time. But I'm also showing love. I'm also showing my other students love. They got this video out on YouTube, Drip Lord. See these pants right here? He's made by one of my students also. I'm gonna show him love. Jordy, 91, he's the one that made these.
We're gonna have a guest speaker in here today. He'll be coming in a little bit. So we'll go ahead and turn it down. And we're gonna be having him come in and everything. So go ahead and give him his respect, be respectful and everything. So we're gonna have someone come in and talk to y'all for a little bit.
So I did this for Eric and whoever made the video, Risky, right? Or chopped it up. Yeah, I did this for you guys. And I also did this for Jordy. So I'm gonna post that all up on my video. I just wanted to make this place like memorable for you. So, all right? So, let's start out with that blue picture, you know, before we get going. And it's gonna be a long day, but I mean, most of you guys are gonna be done, so some of you guys are gonna leave early, so we might not get a blue picture.
Yeah.
So I'll just go ahead and start off with the blue picture, all right?
All right.
Yeah, stand on the chair, kneel down.
More amazing for me than you guys, if you believe that, you know. I try to show you guys a good time, you know, not just about work, you know, things like that.
Next time it's all us.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
I make sure look easy, but they don't know what it take. Don't ask me the time, I got baguettes in the face. Virgil drops on Louis, I want everything he made. When it come to hoes, I never be the one to save. Keep on throwing ones, these bitches keep on showing ass. Bitches on my body and I'm just trying to relax. They always come off cool, but in the end they come out whack. A boyfriend getting mad, I told her he could take you back. Huh? Me and your bitch up in the van, oh. If you wanna back, you better man, oh. I know you just don't understand, oh. She just want you to help her get a dance, oh. Oh, nah, yeah, just ride my wave like a tsunami. I came from the jungle from a safari. I don't want no nigga, I want a menage. Don't give me no hickeys, baby, give me sloppy. I already seen you naked, girl, I know your body. You like fucking with the lights, all for some shy shit. You gon' end up being famous if you talk about it. I make shit look easy, but they don't know what it take. Don't ask me the time, I got baguettes in the face. Virgil drops on Louis, I want everything he made. When it come to hoes, I never be the one to save. Keep on throwing ones, these bitches keep on showing ass. Bitches on my body and I'm just trying to relax. They always come off cool, but in the end they come out whack. A boyfriend getting mad, I told her he could take you back. Lacing up the Jordans, I said that it's game time. Need you to tell me how you really feel. Give you a high you can't get from a pill. Girl, if I tell the truth, then keep it real. Y'all gon' hate me, been working on this daily. Yeah, she pass like a Mercedes. It say 60, I go 80. If you want a favor, pay me. I'm in X drive when it's raining. I don't wanna hear complaining. If you want it, gotta take it. Yeah, you know I got no patience. Better not keep solo waiting. Yeah, yeah. These little dudes think that they all on my way. Tryna travel down the road, I just pay. We talk all day, still don't got your number saved. Just cause I'm solo, everyone wanna hate. I'm on a 3-hour drive, I don't even got the time. If you ever said I wasn't down the ride, then you lie. Little bitch, you lie. You don't know how my team get up on the grind. Yeah, I had to hear your girl off her mind. And I'm saying never mind. You know that I wouldn't lie. Go and fucking be that guy.
Help each other, all right? So whenever you guys do this, and whenever you guys show up next year, whenever we have the reunion, you guys are taking me out.
Yeah.